So here we are on site, another Emmett Leo Homes project, and we're installing this longboard soffit as our siding. And it's a product that I really love, looks really good. When we're looking at building science and what's been going on with water management, the use of rain screens, and it's something that we've been making our guys do. Almost all siding should have an air gap behind it. Now, before you use a product, I would say definitely check with the reps, but you can see above here, we started furring out with 1¼ or 3/8 plywood. And what we did is we ripped it down into very small strips. And it still allows you to not run flush with your windows. So if you run these strips in behind your sidings, it allows it to drain and dry. And that's the big thing with our siding. Water is gonna get behind your siding. It's just a fact, it's going to. But how do we make that dry as efficiently as possible? What it does is it brings it off the wall 3/8 or 10 millimeters, enough to dry, allows the water to drain behind, doesn't allow it to bind to both sides, it's big enough. And that allows our water to come down, hit our flashing, and come off the wall. So all we really did is we used 4x8 sheets of 3/8 plywood. So it doesn't have to be your 1x4, or it can be, but if you're worried about space, I would say your minimum gap has to be 3/8 of an inch or 10 millimeters. So don't install siding unless you do this. Make sure it's a small little thing that breeds big results.